Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. How is everybody? Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome to the 2019 Murrow College Hall of Achievement Ceremony. My name is Mark Wright, Murrow School, class of 1989. Yes, it was only a school back in 1889 before when the state was formed. It's early. I have not had enough coffee yet. How great is it that we have the Murrow College now? I mean, that is fantastic, and thank you so much, you guys. Yeah, you can give that a round of applause. So when I'm not in Pullman, I'm the evening anchor for the NBC affiliate in Seattle, King 5 TV, and I was just walking up to campus yesterday thinking, I can't believe it's been 30 years since I was a student here, and now I'm sitting with some professors over here, and I'm looking at them thinking they're not nearly old enough to be professors. Where does time go? This morning, we are here to honor two really deserving inductees into the Murrow Hall Hall of Achievement. CNN anchor and journalist Ana Cabrera and Jerry Eisenhardt, an iconic figure in media and civic life in Central Washington. Two amazing people that we will hear more about in just a moment. But first, I'd like to recognize the sponsors whose generous support has made the symposium programs possible. I'll read them, and then let's give them a round of applause at the end. At the premier level, we have BECU, Alaska Airlines, InspireUS Credit Union, Fox 12 Oregon, and Cairo 7. At the crimson level, we have the Pullman Chamber of Commerce, Copacino Fujikado, College Hill, Tim and Karen Pavish, Chateau St. Michel, and Kind. And at the gray level, we have KHQ, Weber Shandwick, Crosscut. Let's give them a round of applause. Without their support, you know, we students, we've needed the support over the years, and it's wonderful to have that support. Right now, I'd like to introduce the dean of the college, Murrow College of Communication, a man who has taught and served students at this university for more than 25 years. He's a researcher. He earned tenure and early promotion to full professor. Dr. Bruce Pinkleton has also served in a number of leadership roles here, from graduate, director, associate dean, to interim dean, and now dean. I mentioned that we transitioned from the Murrow School to the Murrow College earlier. And Bruce led the task force that examined that idea and ultimately recommended college status for the Murrow School here. So a huge transition under his leadership. And I'm going to let you guys in on a little secret. Maybe I shouldn't say this, Bruce, but when we journalists come to town every year, we love to know other people's business. And the first thing that we do is gather intel when we come back to campus. And we ask each other, and we ask students, and we ask faculty, so how are things going in the college? How is this dean doing, you guys? And I have to tell you, after talking with a bunch of people, it's really clear that, Bruce, people love you. They love the job that you're doing, as do the staff and faculty here. Bruce is not the kind of guy who would toot his own horn, but I will toot his horn because I really think he is the right guy for the job, the right person for this job right now, and will lead us to really incredible places. So please give a warm welcome to Dr. Bruce Pinkleton, Dean of the Murrow College of Communication.
Thank you. That was outstanding, and I'll pay you later on for that. I wish my mother were here to hear that. She'd actually think I'd become something in my life. So, I just have a few comments to make. So thankful to be here. So grateful to our faculty, staff, and students. By honoring our alumni, we honor the Murrow legacy, and we are inspired by what they've accomplished and who they are as people. To be an outstanding broadcast professional is not enough. It's important that you embody the full range of the Murrow legacy, and we're excited about that today. So I just want to say thank you. I have been at WSU for more than 25 years now, and one of the things that attracted me here and kept me here, I had lunch actually. I'm way off script, Corey, I'm so sorry. But anyway, I had lunch with a student here when I interviewed in February of 1993, I think it was, and she said, Bruce, there's two things you need to know about Washington, she said. You'll hear about Husky pride, but Cougar loyalty. And that Cougar loyalty thing cuts deep, it really does. And I appreciate professional advisory board members coming back at their own expense and investing themselves. And I've heard so many positive comments from the students about their experiences with the panels, and so many positive comments from the professionals about their experiences with students. So thank you very much. So my job is to introduce Bruce Amundson. Bruce has been the head of the Professional Advisory Board for the last 2 years. We're busy ushering him out. I think this is the last time he's officially head of the board. And the two Bruces, Bruce B squared, were awesome together. So Bruce, come on up and take it away.
Thank you. Before I get into my prepared remarks, I just want to echo a little bit of what Bruce said there. This year's symposium, I think, has each one is great, but I think this one has really exceeded what we've done in the past. And I've never seen so much engagement from students this year. Last night, I had a text from Jessamyn McIntyre. She said, I just landed in Seattle. Wanted to thank you again for having me there. And I want you to know how meaningful it was for me to be part of it. So, you know, Jess obviously shared a lot of her knowledge and expertise with the students, but she also got something out of it as well. And I think, you know, speaking for all of the members of the board who participate in this, I think that's the thing that, you know, we all come away also with a little bit of something. So it's a great, great event. So each year during the symposium, we do honor our outstanding alums of the Edward R. Murrow College of Communication who have distinguished themselves throughout their careers. The HOA inductees are peer selected through the Murrow Professional Advisory Board HOA Committee, and the nominees are individuals who have made significant contributions through their business, professional, or academic achievements, demonstrated community involvement that highlights corporate or personal social responsibility, shown support for Washington State University and or the Edward R. Murrow College of Communication, are individuals that often mentor Murrow students or young professionals in their field, and have received honors or awards for these career achievements. When you think we have nearly 14,000 graduates, who all of them have contributed something to our industry, you can imagine how highly valued this prize is when we have so few that are inducted into the Hall of Achievement. If you are an HOA inductee, or will be in the next 15 minutes, please stand and be recognized. I think we have a few. These people and the others who have joined them in the Hall of Achievement are our people, and they epitomize Murrow in action. This class that will be inducted this year is particularly inspiring. Please welcome me, or please, not welcome me, you've already welcomed me. Come on, welcome me again, come on. See, I told you, I told Corey this last night. I said, you know, I was practicing this last night. In fact, I passed up going to the Coug last night so I could practice this. And I was so awesome. And then I get up this morning, and I'm going, I don't know. So I apologize for that. So please welcome Mary Grace Roski, who in addition to having her life fulfilled by getting a picture with Gardner Minshew last night, serves as the Chief Brand Officer for the Seattle Foundation, also participated as a panelist in this year's symposium, and more importantly, serves as our HOA Committee Chairperson. She invests countless hours in the selection process and worked with a very strong committee of Murrow alums whose high standards ensure that only the finest professionals across all aspects of their career are inducted into the Hall of Achievement. So at this time, Mary Grace, if you'll come up and introduce.
So if Mark Wright got to be in the class of 1889, I got to be in the class of 1887, and I'm sure Gardner Minshew would not want to know that someone from the class of 1887 wanted to get their picture taken with him yesterday. So thank you very much, Bruce. I really enjoyed working on the Murrow Hall of Communication, Hall of Achievement program this year. It's been wonderful to be reminded of the caliber of people who come out of Murrow, and having been at the symposium yesterday and seen all the speakers and the jobs they have and the fascinating careers that they've pursued. It's really, it really is wonderful to come back and be a part of that. It's really also very much an honor to be selected to receive this recognition by one's peers, as the caliber of the Murrow grads is really so amazing. It is the highest accolade that one can receive from the Murrow College, and our inductees represent the Murrow legacy in all they create for our industry locally, nationally, and internationally. Before I proceed, I want to thank the people who helped me in this effort. We have three of them who are here today, and if they want to give a wave, that'd be great. Art Ekman was on the committee, Bob Brunko, and Sherry Niebel. So thank you for helping out with our conference calls and reviewing who would be recognized this year. It gives me great pleasure to now introduce our 2019 Hall of Achievement class of inductees. Our first 2019 inductee is a graduate of the Edward R. Murrow College of Communications at Washington State University with degrees in communication, foreign language, and cultures. From her incredible journalism covering riots in Ferguson, Missouri, to marijuana legislation and immigration, Ana Cabrera is part of a small and elite club. In addition to the Hall of Achievement, she is one of few Latina network anchors on the air in prime time. An Emmy Award-winning field reporter, she is now the anchor of CNN's weekend primetime show, CNN Newsroom. Ana serves on the board of directors of Mi Casa Resource Center, the Murrow Professional Advisory Board, and is a member of the National Association of Hispanic Journalists. An inspiration to broadcast journalists everywhere, we are honored to induct Ana into the Hall of Achievement.
I see, journalism in sort of a renaissance period right now, where it's never been as relevant as it is today. When you look to all these different sources that are providing news coverage, it's, there's so many more opportunities in that regard, and the work we do is just so important for our nation. Hi, my name is Ana Cabrera, proud Murrow graduate, 2004. I think along the way there are a few stories that stand out, and the one that stands out from my first job in Spokane was the Groney family murders and kidnappings. And it was within the first 6 months on the job for me, it was the first time I ever covered a story of national significance like that. It was so heart-wrenching and such a tremendous tragedy. It was such a tremendous mystery for so long, for months. And it really impacted me, but I also felt like that's where I found my footing.
He destroyed the final memories I had of my mother.
Now, more recently, I did a story about an investigation into nursing home sex abuse. And being able to help shed light on some of these disheartening realities and really give voice to the voiceless or people who are more and most vulnerable. A degree from the Murrow College is something that's really special. Obviously, the Murrow name means a lot to not just graduates of the Murrow College, but to people across this country and really around the world. And I think now more than ever, Edward R. Murrow's legacy is something that me and my colleagues as journalists look to. I look up to Edward R. Murrow in so many ways and try to emulate what he was able to accomplish and the impact that he was able to have on the industry and on this service and this, this role as a journalist, as somebody who is for the people and is in a position of privilege and power, and it's a tremendous responsibility to do what we do, but has the potential to really make a difference. And so being recognized for the work I do means a lot.
Go Cougs!
So I believe Bruce and Bruce are to join me on stage.
Okay, and we have a picture right here. Thank you. Congratulations, everyone.
I'll be honest, I didn't prepare any remarks because I knew there was going to be the video, and I feel like I said a lot of perhaps what I would say up here in that video, but I do want to at least take a moment to say a couple of things. And I first thank you for being here at this event because I know it's early, and I know it was designed to be early this year because I have to catch a flight back to New York a little bit later this morning. But I want to, you know, just say a few thank yous, because this is such a tremendous honor for me. When I found out I had been selected as the recipient of this award, I was really surprised and shocked because I don't necessarily feel like I'm deserving. I feel like there's still so much more that I want to accomplish in this career and, again, in this role as a journalist. And I look at some of the others who've been inducted, and they've done so much more. And I, you know, want to continue to make the Murrow School proud, and hopefully there's much more to be done in order to do that. But I want to say thank you to the professors here in this room and just at this college, and acknowledge what a difference they've made in my life and in my career. I think, you know, when I first came to WSU prior to being a student here, I came in with a lot of skepticism when I was recruited to run cross country and track and came out on my recruiting trip, because I thought, I'm too good of a student to go to WSU. I was, you know, an A student, and WSU is a party school. That's not me. And what I found is, yeah, WSU is a lot of fun, but not just in the way you think about it, you know? And I can't imagine having received a better education anywhere else, and I feel such a tremendous amount of gratitude for having been at this college and having access to the professors and the resources and the experiences that I received here. And so thank you to those professors for daring us to dream and giving us the tools and nurturing an environment in which we can learn and pursue those dreams. And thank you to many of the peers and colleagues in this room who have provided guidance along the way, mentorship, support, have been brainstorming buddies, and have led by example. And I want to also thank the students in this room who I've enjoyed getting to know a little bit over the past couple of days. And thank you for, again, reminding me how lucky I am to do the work that I do and how exciting it is, how cool the work that we do really is, and also for challenging me and asking good questions and reminding me to continue to push harder and, you know, always be introspective about the work that we're doing, because that's what makes us better. In many ways, I still feel like a student. I feel like I always am saying this, but it's the truth. I never feel like I know enough. I always feel like every day I'm going on to my, you know, preparing for my show, I feel like it's a big cram session, like I'm preparing for a final in many ways, because I just want to be so prepared for, you know, the discussions that we're going to have, and really do seek to understand the heart of the issues and the heart of the stories, and making sure we're delivering the information and the stories that are most relevant to the lives of our viewers at home. And so thank you again for this tremendous honor. Thank you for all that you've given me over the years. And it's so fun to be back here. And hopefully I will continue the Murrow legacy in a way that makes you all proud going forward. And just a word about Murrow again. I think it's extremely special that Edward R. Murrow is attached to our school and our college, because he's timeless. And he's timeless because he is the epitome of what it means to be a good journalist. And what he represents is timeless. It is the gold standard across the board in our industry. You don't have to know Murrow, but he is a master storyteller. And he was so brave and courageous during the work that he did, and his pursuit of the truth and his pursuit of what is, you know, right, and really taking to heart the role of the free press in being the fourth estate and holding elected officials accountable. And I do find myself these days really looking to him as a guiding light during this time where there's this challenge in the current administration being so adversarial against the press, and, you know, just trying to stay true to that core of what Edward R. Murrow represents. And so, Casey Murrow, it's been such a delight to get to know you a little bit over the past couple of years at a couple of different events. And your father means a lot to a lot of us. And thank you for being here, too, and taking the time, because you're that living legacy, truly, in your family. So thanks again for being here, and thank you for the wonderful award.
Thank you, Anna. His senior year at WSU, Jerry Eisenhardt was the Master of Ceremonies for the Amuro Awards Banquet in 1967. Now, 52 years later, we are delighted that he has returned as a Hall Achievement inductee. Jerry graduated from WSU with a degree in broadcast journalism in 1967 and acquired community radio station KOZI in Chelan, Washington, just 2 years later. He sold the station in 1999, but not before this bilingual, bicultural family man served two terms as a Chelan City Council member and one as mayor of Chelan. As a founding member of the Lake Chelan Hospital Foundation, he advocated for open communication to build community trust and grow patronage. I'm proud to induct Jerry Eisenhardt into the 2019 class of Hall of Achievement inductees.
When I was 13, I was very, very sick, and I was in the hospital for several months. And in that period of time, I had no visitors, except I had a Zenith transoceanic shortwave radio at the head of my bed. That's all I did. That was my whole connection to the outside world. When you say it's a nice day, some people don't see it. When you say it's going to snow tomorrow, some people are not in a place to even know. We are the eyes and ears of young Jerry Eisenhardt, who can't get out of their homes. I think the seeds of my interest in and love and value of radio were planted way back then. Hi, I'm Jerry Eisenhardt, a very proud graduate of Murrow College and Washington State University. I had been a math and physics major. So I had gone down to my class advisor down in the engineering building, which was down below Arts Hall. Got my cards, and I was to take them up over to Bowler Gymnasium and get in line and wait, go around the field three times and wait till I got to go in and turn them in. And so as I was walking up that grassy slope, I get up to Arts Hall, and here's an old friend of mine from Wenatchee. His name is John Lindsley. And he said, "Have you ever been through the Department of Communications?" And I said, "No." He said, "Well, it's right here. You got time?" I said, "Sure." So he took me in. Out steps Bob Mott. Robert Mott, the department chairman, and he said, "Mr. Mott, this is my friend Jerry Eisenhardt from Wenatchee, and I'm giving him a tour, and he's down here to register." And he said, "Eisenhardt, come on in, let's talk." And he said, "What are you doing?" I said, "Well, I work in radio part-time as I go to college. That's how I pay to go to college." And he said, "Let me see those cards." And he shuffled them around a little bit, and he reached over here, and he put one here, and pretty soon he said, handed him back, and he said, "Eisenhardt, welcome to the Department of Communications." And that is a fact. That's exactly how I became a student. I think real journalists and real people that are really committed to communications, though, are there not for the money, but for the passion of the mission, which is the mission is to be good communicators of information, facts, truth, and let's get the story told. I'm very, very proud of my Murrow background and my college training, and for sure I know that it served me well. I think about it all the time, and I actually ask myself all the time, am I meeting the standards in everything I do? Go Cougs!
Unfortunately, Jerry is unable to be here in person this morning, but we're delighted to have him here via phone to accept. Good morning, Jerry.
Good morning.
Congratulations on your award.
Thank you so much. And let me say that I'm impressed with the video that Greg Mills and his crew produced. I had made some notes about things I might share and had no idea that most of them would be covered in the video. I am truly honored by this award today. And it's true that when I arrived on the campus in 1965, I didn't have a clue what was going to be coming down the pike and what was ahead. I had transferred as a math major and suddenly found myself enrolled in the Department of Communications thanks to the department chairman, Bob Mott. And that was truly a life-changing moment. Talk about understanding the meaning of serendipity. I knew that I was where I was supposed to be, and it wasn't long before I was working at both the campus stations, KWSU and KUGR, and I was also working part-time at three local commercial radio stations in the area. I quickly realized that I was in the company of an incredible team of professionals that that gathered together, teachers, instructors, and even fellow students. And I can proudly say that I soon became an active member of what we called the Mott Squad. And everyone I know who was in communications at WSU in that era says the same thing. We were an extremely fortunate group of students. Bob Mott and his team were professional educators who had a way with students to motivate them to strive for the very best. And the chemistry of that era produced an impressive group of graduates, most of who went on to pursue very distinguished careers. And it was then that I formed the foundations of my expectations and responsibilities as a journalist. And those who know me know I take that very seriously. I was proudly inducted into both Sigma Delta Chi and Alpha Epsilon Rho, and the values of those organizations are still with me today. And as you mentioned in the video, in my senior year, I was actually Master of Ceremonies of one of the early versions of the same event that we're part of today. In 67, it was a one-day affair. It was called the Edward R. Murrow Awards Banquet. Tickets, by the way, were $2.50. It makes me proud that it has evolved into the impressive tribute today to one of the greatest, Edward R. Murrow. As I was listening yesterday, the opening comments of Jessamyn McIntyre, she was spot on, and I hope that everyone was able to catch her comments. Jessamyn spoke in part about how to advance in this competitive field today. Jessamyn is a very, very wise woman. I hope everybody will make sure they find time to, if they didn't hear her speech, go back and listen to it. Interestingly, out of my experience at the 1967 banquet, I was hired for my very first postgraduate job directly because of a contact and impression I made at that event. That was in 1967. And 2 years later, in 69, the owner of the radio station at Lake Chelan actually looked me up and said he wanted me to come by his radio station, telling me that he had followed my career at WSU and thought that I had what it would take to be successful in a small market radio. I was 24 years old when he made that contact. As he talked to me, I learned he was fully aware of who I was and what I had done at Washington State University, primarily due to the hometown news service, which the university had and sent photos and press releases about the success stories of their students back to the students' hometown media. Who would have ever guessed what that would lead to? I have so much to be grateful for. I spent 30 years from 1969 through 99 as the owner-operator of a most unusual award-winning small-town radio station, KOZI, and another 14 years exploring online what a communications graduate could do with the internet and a website that was called Go Lake Chelan. An incredible experience in journalism. For all of this, I have a lot to say thank you. Thank you to the Edward R. Murrow College of Communications, and thank you to Washington State. Of course, I want to say a huge thank you for this honor today. I am deeply touched. I wish I were more healthy and I could be there in person, but in the meantime, let me say, go Cougs.
Thank you. Jerry, thank you so much for calling in today. We're so happy that you were able to be part of the ceremony in this way. And Bob Brunko is going to step forward to accept the award on your behalf.
Thank you. Thank you, Bob.
Let's give both of our inductees a final round of applause.
Mary Grace, thank you, and thanks for the work that you do with Seattle Foundation. Keep up the good work. So Anna and Jerry, congrats. What a well-deserved recognition to you both. You really both do all of us proud, and you're honoring the legacy of Ed Morrow. And in doing so, you're inspiring students who see in you what is possible. So congratulations. You know, something hit me when Jerry was talking, and it really resonated deeply with me. Jerry said, when I came to the Morrow School, I felt that I was where I was supposed to be. And honestly, my career, I was flunking out in the business school, honestly, and I was completely lost in college. And when I finally found the Morrow School, it, for the first time in my life, you know, academically, I felt I was supposed where I was supposed to be. And I think that's a beautiful thing, that this college doesn't just train people to be journalists. It helps them find their role in life and their position in life. And that doesn't happen in a vacuum. Dean Pinkleton, faculty, staff here today, Anna said that earlier, but I think it's worth restating. We would not be where we are today without all of you and the dedication and the time, the professors and the staff members who took us under their wings when we were students who didn't know anything about anything. You took us under your wings and you helped us develop. We spent an hour last night with Glenn Johnson in the Coug, just catching up and hugs and just, it's that kind of a connection that students get here. You don't just have teachers or professors, you develop lifelong friendships with your mentors, and that's one of the things I love and cherish about the Morrow College. Once again, I just wanted to recognize Casey Morrow again. Casey, can you stand up? We'd like to recognize you once again for being here. It is, you know, it's really an honor that you're here, Casey. It says a lot about you, and it says a lot about your family that you take the time to be here to honor your dad and to help us continue his mission, which is so important to all of us. So thank you so much for being here. It's such a treat. So this year's 44th Morrow Symposium, Storytelling for Impact, as you all know, offers the current students really that chance to interact with alums, to get a feel for what's happening in the real world. And we're so fortunate to have all of you. So I just wanted to thank all of you who are here on your own time to help mentor these students and help them find their way. Thank you for coming. I hope you come back next year. So we're going to wrap up things here for this morning's breakfast, but the symposium is far from over. We have all kinds of panels. We have career advice, coaching, workshops ahead. So thanks, everybody, for coming to the Hall of Achievement ceremony this morning. Congrats again to those inducted, and have a great rest of your day. Thanks.